Hello viewers, welcome to a special bulletin on the Panji wetland. You must have heard about the Panji wetland, which is in urban area, which has been under attack from infrastructure project proponents for a long time.
Hello friends, I'm Nandakumar Pawar from Sri Ekviraya Pratishthan. Today I just want to discuss with you the Panji wetland issue of Uran Taluka. You must have heard about the Panji wetland, which is supposed to be the highly biodiverse wetlands, last remaining surviving wetland of Uran Taluka, under tremendous threat from the Reliance SEZ.
And we as environmentalists have been trying our level best to protect the land. In fact, we have complained to the mangrove committee appointed by the High Court, and the committee has ordered the CIDCO and the local administration, district administration, to protect the area as a wetland, though it may not have been declared as a wetland under the atlas, but it has all the characteristics of a wetland. So, which is why the mangrove committee has ordered it to be protected, and the environment minister Aditya Thackeray has ordered that there should be no fresh construction in the area. The MCZMA, on its part, the Maharashtra Coastal Zone Management Authority, has committed, in fact, has submitted to Bombay High Court, saying that Panji wetland, the another holding pond in Dronagiri area, holding pond number 2, the both of these come under CRZ-1, which is why if any construction has to take place, they need to take a prior permission. But despite which, there have been a lot of attempts to do landfilling in the area. In fact, NMSEZ has already constructed a huge compound wall. CIDCO has built sluice gates to regulate the flow of tidal water into the wetland.
This wetland area spread across 289 hectares. There are 4 villages on the periphery of this wetland area, namely Panje, Funde, Dongri and Bori Pakhadi. This area CIDCO maintains as a holding pond supposed to control flood in the Dronagiri node. Mysteriously, CIDCO has sold this area to Reliance SEZ, which is completely wrong, and we condemn that decision of the CIDCO to sell this ecological sensitive wetland area.
But this is very process of regulating the water and stopping the water flow during the high tide into Panji area has led to the area, you know, becoming dry, which is where last year, if you notice, there are not been many birds landing in that area. So normally you have between 1.5 to 5 lakh birds, you know, making their destination. So, which is why the mangrove committee has ordered it to be protected, and the environment minister Aditya Thackeray has ordered that there should be no fresh construction in the area.
This wetland area essentially salt pans earlier. CIDCO has acquired this area in 1971 under the Land Acquisition Act 1885.
And that is a beautiful scenario. Apart from just being a bird destination, it's a biodiversity area. It's very ecologically sensitive area. Part of Panji has been a salt pan, and as the revenue department acquired it, so the land actually belongs to the government of Maharashtra. So, but CIDCO yet, you know, has sold most of this land to NMSEZ.
Now we have heard about many controversies that are happening in Panji area. We heard about the blocking of tidal water, the wetland turned dry, birds have no water, and so on. This is very disturbing, and this is the violation of the law and order. This issue is already in the Honorable Bombay High Court, and the Bombay High Court and the MCZMA has categorically said that this area is CRZ1 area and no activities can be carried out on this area unless the prior permission and clearance seek from the Honorable Bombay High Court. Still, Reliance SEZ is operating in this area illegally. They have maintained special cell who operates in this area, and their task is to block tidal water, chop mangroves in the night. And Reliance paying salaries to these people to operate for them and work for them. Also, the local Western interests also indulge and giving all support and helping hand to Reliance SEZ for the sake of money, which is very, very disturbing and very sad.
Another dichotomy is that CIDCO itself is part of NMSEZ. In fact, they hold 26% share in NMSEZ. So these are the issues that which we have been fighting, and we have again repeatedly asked the state government to declare Panji as a bird sanctuary so that the area will be protected, and the biodiversity of Uran will be maintained.
The APCCF of Maharashtra, Shri Virendra Tiwari, have declared this area as a conservation reserve. Still, this area under the illegal control of Reliance, and often Reliance security guards in the local gram panchayat stopping people from entering into the Panji wetland. They preventing birders from taking any kind of photo. They say you go to the police station, seek their prior permission. The police says our permission is no longer required. Still, what's happening? This is a very sensitive issue. The peak season is around the corner, and I appeal and request to the authority, the government of Maharashtra, the CM of Maharashtra, to look into this matter urgently and seriously and declare this area as a protected area, this flamingo sanctuary, a sanctuary for the migratory birds. Thank you very much.